This is the Boost XL Cap Keypad, the entry-level tool used to evaluate MSP430 Captivate Touch technology for capacitive sensing, and developed with the MSP430FR2512 and MSP430FR2522 microcontrollers. This video will walk you through the steps required to develop with the Cap Keypad Booster Pack using the Captivate Programmer module. The Programmer module is included as part of the Captivate Development Kit, or can be purchased separately. Combining the Booster Pack with the Programmer allows you to modify the preloaded software for the Cap Keypad Booster Pack. You can adjust the sensitivity of the buttons, the proximity sensor, and the guard channel. You can also control the LED backlighting. Let's get started. Visit the link shown to download and install the latest version of Captivate Design Center on your computer. Captivate Design Center is an easy-to-use development environment enabling you to create your very own capacitive sensing design in minutes. Connect the Cap Keypad to the Programmer module using the connector at the top of the Booster Pack. Then connect the Programmer board to your computer using a micro USB cable. You'll notice that the LEDs light up, indicating the boards are powered. When the MCU enters sleep mode, the backlight LEDs will turn off. Use the capacitive proximity feature to wake up the board with a hand swipe and touch a couple of buttons. Notice the awake and detect LEDs illuminate when a button has been touched and the MCU is in active mode again. Open Captivate Design Center on your computer by double-clicking the shortcut on the desktop. Go to File, then Project Open. In the dialog box, click on the Boost XL Cap Keypad folder and press Select. You should see three objects: the MSP430FR2522 controller, the keypad sensor button group, and the proximity sensor button group. Go to Communications and Connect to enable target communications to the Cap Keypad Booster Pack from the Programmer. Touch a couple of buttons on the keypad. Notice that the status of the button is highlighted on the screen. Double-click on the keypad sensor group and a dialog box opens as shown on the channel bar chart tab. This tab is for examining capacitive sensing threshold. Touch the number 1 key on the keypad with varying levels of force to see the result on screen. Click the screen and draw a box around the number 1 channel to zoom in. The orange line represents the proximity sensing threshold, and the green represents the touch threshold to prevent false touches. Switch over to the channel oscilloscope plot tab. Here you can examine filter performance and noise immunity. Slowly bring your hand near the keypad. Notice the response on screen increases as the distance between the hand and the keypad is reduced. Now pull your hand away. You'll notice the opposite effect as the signal attenuates the further your hand is from the keypad. This concludes the out-of-box demonstration of the Boost XL Cap Keypad with the Captivate Programmer and Captivate Design Center. To learn more about the kit and other out-of-box demos, please visit the link shown. Happy developing!